law. Jesus said, this day shall thou be with me in paradise.
Thank you for being here again. Thank you for visiting me on this Wednesday, Eastern Standard Time, 6 o'clock. God is good, and we will definitely give you the word of God tonight, as God has called me to be one that preached sound doctrine. Tonight, a very, very peculiar topic, and a topic that everyone has been questioning and asking about and had great concerns. And tonight, we will get answers through the very word of God tonight. No thoughts, no ideas, no passed down, no mixture, but that which the word of God has spoken unto us, that will I proclaim to you on tonight. My friend, I thank you again. Already we've reached so many people. We are all over the place now, just reaching people in all different cities and different countries. And I thank God for that, because do you not know that the devil is busy? The devil has so many people who's working for him, so many preachers that's working for him, so many leaders who have gotten into seats over synagogues and churches and have misled people and led them astray, mixing the word of God with politics, what they feel, what they think, their ideologies, and most of all, only use the word of God or the name of Jesus when it's convenient to throw it in there when there's a need. But tonight, we're going to find out who is that true man and what is he doing. Tonight, as a minister of the Lord Jesus Christ, I claim not to be one who I've attained. As Paul has said, I have not obtained. Even though I know I'm not a whit behind no man, but yet I know that I am called by God to give you the word of God. I stay humble in that. My friend, again, now we have so many things I want to bring to you tonight. And what we have tonight is the word of God that will make you have an understanding. For Jesus said, in all thy getting, get understanding. And if we preach the word of God, the gospel of Jesus Christ, and the man don't receive understanding, then what are we preaching? If we preach and it be not that which is written, then what are we preaching? If we preach and it's not for correction or for edification or for your need, as God has given the word to give to his people, then what are we doing? Tonight, we're going to find out some things, some very important key issues that you had throughout your walk. So many people have asked these questions, and it's pretty bad when nobody will answer the question when it's right in the word of God, which we're going to talk about tonight. And tonight, I pray that all thy getting, you get understanding in the name of the Lord. I will not hold you any longer. But now, this is a time now where we will get into the word of the Lord. My friend, get ready as we go to the word of the Lord. Get your Bibles tonight. As you can see, normally I will give you a topic or discussion after that I've read a scripture. But tonight, because of the topic and because of the questionings and the concerns that people have, God has given me text that will reach you in your hearts and show you what is supposed to be and what is not. My friend, let me explain to you something, that I am just a minister. I seek not for ordination in any other field. If God so that it be, I will not tell God no. But I'm glad that I have not this big ministry. I'm glad that I have none of these things, none of these finances and all these things. I have my own job. Now, I'm not telling you, as the message tonight will explain to you some things, the message will tell you what is true and what is not concerning the topic that you see here on your screen, preaching for payment. Is it okay to preach for payment? Should I be preaching for the payment, which is the reward in heaven? Or should I preach for the payment here? And should I receive payment here, even though I am going to receive the reward of payment in heaven? Tonight, my friend, the word of the Lord is going to come to you and show you. But before we get into some other scripture, we have to first place the scripture of foundation that will show you the truth. Get your Bibles. And now, at this portion of time, I will bring the first scripture. And the first scripture is one that you're familiar with. It should be appearing on your screen in just a second. Watch this. I'm going to read this because some of us had read the scripture, and for some reason have not read all. Listen. 1 Timothy 6 chapter 10th to the 12th verse. Watch this. For the love of money is the root of all evil. Stop right there. So many people say money is the root of all evil, when God have never told us that we should not have money. But to love it more than God is the root of all evil. Wait a minute. All evil? There's so much evil in the world. There's so much evil coming from that devil, Lucifer, that dark angel, that dragon, that trickster, who comes in Revelation said, woe unto you who are in the earth. For the devil, Lucifer, that dark angel, that dragon, coming to the earth with a fiery vengeance upon all mankind. So you mean to tell me that devil, with all that evil that can happen in the life of mankind, the love of money is the root of all evil? Some of us say money is the root of all. God never said that money is, but the love of it is. But here's where we stop. This is where we stop. But let's see what the second portion of this scripture says. We're talking about preaching for payment. He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit has to say to the church. For the Bible says in the second portion of this text, which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. Stop. Stop right there. Sorry about that. Stop right there. The Bible says that we who have loved money, which is the root of all evil, have coveted after this. And when a man covet this, when a man go after this with his whole heart, and he go after this type of thing, every his reason is for the money, he shall err from God. Because you can't go to which is all evil, which the first part said the love of money is the root of all evil. You can't go to all evil and believe that you have not erred from God. So then they erred from the faith. From the faith? Good Lord Almighty. Let's find out now, is this happening today? We're going to find out something we haven't gotten there yet. Bear with me. We have erred, preachers, from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. But watch this right here. Verse 11. But thou, O man of God. Wait a minute, Lord. Who are you speaking to here? Because we don't read this. We read about the money. But we don't read this. But thou, O man of God, flee these things. Good God, I felt the power of God. Flee these things and follow after righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, meekness. See, those are the fruits of the Spirit. Those are parts of the fruits of the Spirit right there. Not all seven, but not all the fruits of the Spirit here. But it's talking to us, preachers. But thou, O man of God, flee these things. Flee from loving money. Flee from setting your affections on things here in the earth and not on that which is in heaven. I'm telling y'all, we're going to get some word here tonight. For the power of God is going to show you something, preaching for payment. We're going to answer your questions tonight. But the foundation here must be set. So then the word of God said, but O man of God, flee these things. Flee what? Flee from the love of money, that you don't be pierced and err from the faith. But it tells us to follow after righteousness. Where does righteousness come from? Comes from God. Godliness comes from God. Faith is that of God. Love from God. Patience from God. Meekness is all of God. It is the same attributes of our high priest, which is the head of the church, Jesus Christ. And if we say we're Christians or Christ-like or children of God, then we will follow this, even the manservant. So he's talking first to the angels who he has sent to preach the gospel, which Ephesians 4 chapter 11 verse tells you who they are. Some he called prophets, some he called evangelists, some he called preachers or pastors, teachers. Because for what? For the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, and for the perfecting of the saints, so that we all come into the unity of the faith. That's what we were called to do, to preach the gospel. Not to love those things which in our time past, in our sinful life, as the sinner's love or the heathen love, love only God first, the one who gives the blessing. the foundation here. We haven't even gotten into the word yet. The part that, the questioning part, that people have questions about. But already you can see the word is breaking it down, telling us to stay a certain way. And here's the 12th verse. Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, whereunto thou art also called, and hast professed a good profession before many witnesses. Look at this. Look how the word of God break that down. This show me that if we don't, as preachers, because it talked here about thou, O man of God, that's a man who was called of God. You can't be a man of God without God calling you. So we're talking to preachers and people. Listen, if you are a person who follow a ministry, or you are a preacher, my brother, listen to the words of the Lord that comes for all of us. Verily, verily, I say unto you, which is truly, truly, and that truth can't come just from me. It's got to come from the word. And so I preach that which God has given me. That we have a problem in this last day now. And I'm going to show you in the scripture where it's coming from, how we got here. And what is right? What is right? Preaching for payment is what we're talking about. Preaching for payment. Preaching for payment. Now, why should I preach for payment? Isn't it a call of God? That's what the scripture just told you before we left over to the other page. That's what scripture says here in 1 Timothy. At the bottom, 12th verse, it says on the bottom of your screen, or over here, yes, it says that we're called and has professed a good profession before many witnesses. When you're called to be a minister, it is not a hidden thing. Everybody see you because you're the one who's professing and proclaiming the name of the Lord. You're up front. You're the forerunner. You're called the angel of the church or the angel of that particular place where you're preaching. It's not just pastors. It goes beyond pastor. But many people grow on to be a pastor rather than an evangelist, rather than a teacher. People running for titles. But we're going to see who's preaching for the payment of heaven, for the payment of earth. Another passage of scripture I want you to see. Watch this. Watch this. Another passage of scripture. What I want you to see is how now we've gotten off. Let's see what the Apostle Paul had to say through Jesus Christ of how we must be, what we must do. Watch this. Turn now to 1 Corinthians, 9th chapter. I will begin reading at the 13th verse. He that has an ear, let him hear. We're talking about preaching for payment. Well, Paul opens it up and said, listen to this. Do ye know that they which minister about holy things live of the things of the, watch this here, of the temple? And they which wait at the altar are partakers with the altar. The answer is here. That preachers, but listen to what he said now. Do ye not know? Because apparently somebody didn't know. He's talking to the Corinthian church, which is for all of us. Did you not know that they which minister about holy things live of the things of the temple. Stop right there. The problem is, help me, Holy Ghost, that we are no longer preaching holy things. We're preaching everything except the gospel. The gospel is the truth of God, which is that which Jesus had given to all of us to preach and go out into the highways and the hedges, go to the rooftops, go into the temples and preach this gospel. We're not preaching gospel no more from the pulpits. The pulpit has become a stage. The Bible now is just a cover for another message that's not of God. It's not holy no more. So yes, the church, if that preacher is called of God, and yes, if he, that preacher, whatever his title, is preaching holy things, good God Almighty. If he's preaching holy things, the Bible says that he lived from the things of the temple. That means that we're supposed to bless that man. You, as well as myself, I've been raised up in ministry since I was a child. I've served the late Bishop C.O. Long for a lot of years, the man of God, and was a great giver. Went through 17 years of prodigalism. God called me back to preach the gospel in another way, a way now where I'm not attached so much that I can't preach the sound doctrine, afraid that I'm going to lose somebody, or afraid that I'm going to lose a family member, or afraid that I'm going to lose a friend. Now I can freely preach the gospel of Jesus Christ without contingency, without attachment and fear that what I preach, that God give me, somebody not going to like me and separate. But at some point in my time, after seeing so many preachers with so many things and the people suffer, I begin to question even why do they need to have all this finance? I had to question it. God, is that true? Is that why everybody not running to be an evangelist or teacher? They're running for the pastor. Even though they become prophet, they run to be pastor, prophet, pastor, apostle, pastor. Not evangelist, pastor. They're running to be pastor, pastor, pastor. So it doesn't mean people, which means money. That's the wrong payment, because somebody have erred from why you were called. I just told you in Ephesians 4 chapter why we were called. All of the calling that God is calling under shepherds. God called under shepherds over his people so that they can feed his sheep. God gives the under shepherd, the shepherd gives the under shepherd the word, and the under shepherd gives that word to God's people. But now, even though they knew about this benefit, because Paul, some people didn't know, because Paul said, did you know? Because some people even today don't know. So they say, man, I'm not going to the church. All they want is money. And yes, it has been abused. What we are privy to has been abused. I have not received no money like this from people. I don't ask for the much. I have a donation line here, but I don't beg nobody. I put it on at the end. That's it. That's all. Because my greatest reward is that which comes from God. I will rather have the reward of heaven, which I press toward that prize for of God and the higher calling,
The higher calling of God in Christ Jesus. That's what I press for. But some preachers are pressing for your pockets. Let's break that down. See what the Word of God has to say. Again, let's go to the book. The 14th verse says, even so hath the Lord ordained that they which preach the gospel should live of the gospel. Your question has been answered in that area. Should a preacher receive money? The Bible says so, that he should live off the same gospel wherein he is preaching. But let that man be called of God. Let that man be in his heart, sure of his call, and careful with how he get this payment from the people. Because some have over excessively, aggressively, and greedily, a filthy lucre has gained so much, it's causing the people to wander and fall and come short of the glory because of this. Under pressure, pay me before you pay your house bill. God never said that. God never said that. Never said you should go and break your 401k to give to us. Never said that you should give all these different sums of money from every different way. After the preacher has been taken care of, how much more do you need to be taken care of? I'm a preacher. I'm telling you what the word says. 14th verse says, even so hath the Lord ordained that they which preach the gospel should live of the gospel. That's live, not supersede living. But the problem is, some people are starting to preach for payment. Way above what God said. Listen to this. Before I go too far, I'm going to finish this, but I want you to see something in Matthew's 10th chapter, or 10th chapter and 10th verse. I'm going to read this real quick, and I'm going to jump back and show you something. The Bible says, or should I say, I'm going to read this 5 verses to show you something real quick, because it's something you need to know. These 12 Jesus sent forth and commanded them, saying, go not unto the way of the Gentiles, and into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And as ye go, preach, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. See, that goes back to that scripture that shows you that they need to be preaching that which is holy. That's the first thing you should hear here in this verse. And as ye go, preach, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand, heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out devils, and freely ye have received, freely give. That's the spirit and the anointing of God, the word of God that has been freely given to you, this liberty on the inside, freely give that to other people. Now, remember here, and this text, this is Jesus speaking here. Here he's talking about people who are sick, people who are dead, people who are down, people who are poor. So then God is not sending us to preach to people to gain money from them, to get their necessities, and they already don't have it. God is sending us to preach the gospel to them, heal them, give them and freely give to them what Jesus Christ has freely given unto us. Then he said, listen, provide neither gold nor silver nor brass in your purses. But here's what he wants you to do. See, he wants his men servants, he wants us to be provided what we need. Watch this. Take no scrip for your journey, neither two coats, neither shoes, nor your staffs, for your workman is worthy of his meat. That collaborative with what Paul is speaking here in 1 Corinthians. So Paul is not outside the word. But what Paul wants you to understand here, that now we have a problem here, and I'm going to get down to it. People have taken this thing called payment or money or finances too far. Some have 3 and 8 lit jets, have mansions, and another mansion that they say is the place where we're going to meet to talk. And only 3 or 4 or 5 people meeting. You need a mansion for a meeting? Something is wrong. When you have people in the sanctuary who are dying, God never meant it to be that way. He wants his manservant who are traveling, going places, ministering the truth to be taken care of. Not to be filthy above and beyond, to the point where it goes back to the scripture to tell you back that we now have gotten carnal in our minds and have loved money and have erred from God, from the faith. That's what's happening to the preachers today. Those of us who have gained so much necessity, way above our means, killing our own sheep, which belongs to God, for the sake of our own self-gain. We elevate our families with the same money and tell you, go work and believe God for it. That's not what God says to do.
Let's read. Let's not go too far. Listen, there is a difference between being financially blessed by God for the call, which has to be that you have the mindset to please God, versus using the call for gaining finances. If you use this call to gain finance, or you know what, man, I'm gonna go be a preacher. I'm talking about a pastor. Why? Man, all of them, man, they got everything. Look at every church, look in the front. You see a beautiful, beautiful big old car. You see a beautiful edifice. You see all of them living good, living large, all the kids in college, blah, blah, blah. And now there's come a problem within the church. The body of Christ, the people now are faming themselves as preachers having a lot, and people think that this is the body of Christ that's doing this. They're making the things of God of none effect with their ineffective mindsets.
We're going to get to it. Preaching for payment. Watch this. Let's read. Paul says, let me read back at 14, because it says, even so hath the Lord ordained that they which preach the gospel should live of the gospel. Now, see, I'm preaching the gospel. I don't have those finances, but when they come, they come. They don't come, and I'm no way I can take this money, see people of injury, and don't help. There should be something set up for helping people. I can't go to the other side of Jordan and leave my people on the other side. When Moses came, when God told Moses, go down to Pharaoh and tell him, let my people go. And Moses took the people and they left. Even a mixed multitude followed them out of Egypt. They left with riches, but they left with riches. Not just Moses, they left with riches. So when they went across the Red Sea, when Moses went across the Red Sea, they went across the Red Sea. When the death angel came through to slay the Egyptians, it did not touch Moses, neither the sheep or the people of God. When pestilence came, it didn't touch the people of God. It touched the people who were enemies. Basically, what I'm telling you is where the preacher go, the people supposed to go. Something is wrong with the preachers now. Something wrong with us. We started off right. But Paul said you did run well, but who hindered you? Preaching for payment. So let's read verse 15. But I have used none of these things. See, after Paul said that you're supposed to receive money, those who preach the gospel supposed to live of the gospel. But Paul said here in 15th verse, but I have used none of these things. Neither have I written these things that it should be so done unto me. Paul said, I didn't tell none of my church members, y'all got to do this for me. Now that's Paul's preference, because it's written that he can get it. But let's see why Paul didn't want it. Why didn't Paul want this when it's privy to him? It's privileged to him according to that which is written. Paul saw something in other churches and other men, servants, and Paul came to some conclusions. So Paul says this. So Paul says in the 15th verse, but I have used none of these things, neither have I written these things that it should be done so unto me. For it were better for me to die than that any man should make my glory void. What Paul was saying here is that Paul was saying, listen, all that you're talking about, the principle is that I don't want to see or make people believe that I'm only preaching for the payment. When I was called by God, while I was on my way to Damascus, I know God called me when I already, listen, I wasn't preaching for no money. God called me without the money. I found out later as I'm preaching about this thing called money that I can receive while preaching the gospel. But listen to me, I don't want it because I know that it's going to make me void of who I am in God. Paul says, better for me to die than that any man should make my glorying void. See, my glorying is in doing God's will without money. My glorying is doing the things of God, preaching the gospel, which I press toward this mark to do so. I press because I know that I don't deserve this. Paul said, I was chief of sinners. Even though I was circumcised the eighth day, born as a Jew, I was over a great group. I was and unto these Pharisees, I was the greatest. I had more zeal than them. Even though I'd been to all the seminaries and the schools and learned all these things and had so much power to kill saints and friends, even though I had all of this, I count all of that as dung for the will and for the sake of Jesus Christ. So I'm not in this thing for the money, for the payment. But because of the call that God had found me worthy, I don't deserve the call, but I thank God for the call. We're talking about preaching for payment. Let's read. So Paul says in the 16th verse, for though I preach the gospel, though I preach the gospel, I have nothing to glory of. For necessity is laid upon me. Yea, woe is unto me if I preach not the gospel. Good God Almighty. See, there's some preachers now that's preaching, don't care nothing about this. They're doing what they want to do. They're gaining the money and think that God don't see it. And they use Jesus, put on the clergy collar, and act like in their hearts that they are doing the right thing unto you. And then pressure you, lock the doors. Nobody walk. Tell the ushers, lock them doors. Nobody walk when it's time to give. Something wrong. Something wrong. Because it was not said that way. That you ought to be pressured into finances. Okay, I'm a preacher and I've developed all these reasons why you should give. Club, auxiliary, choir, tithe, offerings, all of these things, special offerings. So I got 8 different ways I want you to give to me. And then I tell you, when you tell me I'm getting ready to get put out tomorrow, the pastor's not available to be talked to right now. You have to bring us some proof. Now, I know everybody needs to prove their situation. But do you see the upside down and how we have erred what the Bible told us in the first text that we read? How we've erred from the faith by having this love of money? And it talked to first the preachers. It talked to first the leaders. How we have erred following after that dollar. And now we're preaching only for the payment and still not preaching the gospel. So if I'm not preaching the gospel, I'm preaching gossip. If it's not the gospel, which we were called to preach, there was only one message, only one mission from Jesus Christ that we ought to preach, and that is the gospel of Jesus Christ. Nothing else. All this stuff about all this stuff and stuff and stuff and about all, get away from these people. They're not a part of my clique or not a part of my dream and all these things that people are preaching. That's not the gospel. That's your self-willed story. That's your feelings. That's not the gospel. You deserve no payment for that. Misleading God's people. Let's go to the book. So Paul said, I don't want this on me. For if I do these things willingly, 17 verse, for if I do this thing willingly, I have a reward. See, Paul said, if I do this willingly, as my will to serve God, money or no money, offerings or no offerings, poor or rich, up or down, no matter which way it is, I'm going to preach this gospel. And that's who I am today. I'm going to preach this gospel, studio or no studio, pulpit in the church or pulpit in the street. I'm going to preach this gospel because of my love for Jesus the Christ. I know where he brought me from. I know where I was going. I know what he did for me to bring me to this place. For if I do this thing willingly, I have a reward. But if against my will, a dispensation of the gospel is committed unto me. Look at that. If I do this thing this way, if I do this thing the way it would be bad for me that the gospel is committed unto me, this dispensation of the gospel, meaning that I'm a bad steward. I'm not doing right by God. I'm misusing my clergy collar, my authority. And my heart is not right. I'm not following the will of God and looking for a payment here in the earth. And I'm going to tell you right now, y'all better hear this. He that has an ear, let him hear. Preacher, if you're receiving payment, your heart is for that payment, woe unto you, because you will only receive that payment, will never receive the reward in heaven. Because it is only ordained for you to seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. But don't seek these things and forget about the kingdom. Look at my time running out. God, y'all better hear this. God calls a man to preach what he say, that will be what you need. God does not or has not called a man to preach what you want to hear. Because the Bible said there are people who heaping up preachers for their own self, having itching ears. They're following what they want to hear. And that's what some of these mega preachers are preaching, things that you want to hear. Oh, tell yourself I'm somebody. Oh, All of us are going to go blah, blah, blah. And they say all these things. Say I'm somebody. And I understand. But after you tell people that they're somebody, tell them that they ought to be somebody in Christ. After you tell them that they're a king's kid, tell them that they got to live according to the king's word. After you tell them that they can receive finances and great finances, tell them don't set your affections here, set your affections up there. You're not preaching the gospel. You're preaching fluff. Things that they want to hear instead of the things that God sent a man to preach what people need for real in their life. Preaching for payment. If money was removed from the scripture that preachers ought not receive it, you will have multitudes of preachers that will close their church, close their books, and walk out of the pulpits because their only reason for doing it is for the payment here in the earth. That's sad. We have a problem. Listen to this. Can a preacher receive finance? We've answered that. Yes. Are the people supposed to be threatened to give? No. The scripture says that God loves a cheerful giver. A cheerful giver, those from their heart desire to give. Should the church or the gospel pay for the pastor's living? Yes. But watch this here. Everything in life has a order. Everything, even in the spiritual life, there is order in how things must be. Remember when God told Moses to speak to the rock so that the people can have water, so his people can drink? Moses smote the rock. Even though God still gave the water to his people, because that was God's whole movement and idea to do, was to receive, give his people water to drink. But Moses did something that was not in line or in within the order of God, which Moses took upon himself to smote the rock out of anger instead of speak to the rock as God had told him to do. So thus, Moses stepped outside of that which he's supposed to do. So when we come into this area of saying, should the preacher be taking care of his living, which the word of God says it, his living has to be a normal life. Nowhere show me here have I read that the preacher should be filthy rich or should have many mansions here in the earth and his people have nothing. I have not read that. And I'm talking about preachers. I'm one myself. Everything, when it comes to the word of God, starts from the head first. You read in Revelations about the seven churches, when God saw, or Jesus spoke to John at the Isle of Patmos in a vision and told him about the seven churches, Laodicea, Thyatira, Pergamos, or Pergamum, and he started talking about these churches, and he was telling them of woe unto you, angels of the church. He started speaking to the angels of the church because it's very important that the leader, because people who are sheep are trying to look for some direction. And we have taken that direction knowingly that the people are in need of a word, and we have pimped the people through the word of God thinking that we're going to get away free. Preaching for payment. So let's close. I'm going to have a few things to say. I have so much to read to you, and I didn't get finished my text. But listen to this. The intent of heart, evil reason, false prophets are all abusing the position. They have made the things of God of none effect. And you think that for a reason, any moment that you're going to get free after Jesus died on the cross to set the mission and to restore order in the body of Christ, to go out after dying on the cross, to build a church, to build a people for himself, and you scatter those people through your financial greed. You think that you're going to be all right. Woe unto you, the Bible says, who scatter my sheep, preaching for payment. I want to show you one more thing, and I don't have time. When you get a chance, read Acts 13 and 2. Read when Paul began to preach. In fact, let me see if I can squeeze it in right quick. Second verse of Acts 13. As they ministered to the Lord and fasted, the Holy Ghost said, "Separate me, Barnabas and Saul, for the work whereunto I have called them." You see that? The Bible says, the Holy Ghost said. So then every man's servant that is preaching to people and have set themselves as pastors must first be called of the Holy Ghost. For how can he preach except he been sent? And if he not have been sent by God, he have been sent by the devil. There's only two. Either you're sent by God, and the devil is not God's rival or not God's equal. He's a rival. He's an enemy that comes against the things of God. But the devil is not God's equal. But you either follow the master, Jesus the Christ, or you follow the prince of the power of the air, which is that devil. And he too have preachers whom he sent. A true man of God will care for the sheep, not for his pocket. A true man of God will care for your soul and not just for the number of membership. A true shepherd, a true preacher that deserve payment is that one who have listened and obeyed God. A true preacher who deserve payment, as the scripture has said here. That preacher must be one who has not erred from the faith, but comes with love and faith and patience and meekness and humbleness to the people to show them the way to Christ. Even if it comes to reprimand, he seeks God's advice and seeks God's word and how he should deal with God's sheep. He's not going to make himself Lord over God's people, Lord over God's people money, Lord over God's people houses and God's people land. Preacher that deserve payment is the preacher who labor in the things of God, labor in the work of the Lord, labor in the holy things of God, to lead you and guide you into all truth. That is the preacher who deserves payment. Any other, I will withhold my pocket. You have not done God wrong if you hold your tithing from a false prophet. You have not done wrong if you hold your money from giving to those prosperity preachers who think that they are above God. You've done a good thing to not strengthen the hands of the wicked, for they are wicked and deserve no payment. But only those who's preaching for the payment of righteousness, who's preaching to gain access to Christ, preaching to lead you toward that which is true, that preacher deserves to be taken care of. He deserves to eat right. He deserves, him and his family deserves to be taken up and shown double honor because of God, because of his laboring. But there are some that misuse this, care nothing about you. In fact, a true preacher, if you can be missing for 3 weeks and some preachers won't even ask about you, that show you they care the less. They think the worst instead of saying, go down to their house and show them what's going on. When you go, take some flowers, take some money or something. Take something for them to eat. Show them some love when you go. Tell them we love you. We care for you. We miss you. Come back to the house. That's the true preacher, the true man of God who will show you that love. Some preachers, when you're missing, they say nothing about you. In fact, when you're gone, they speak down on you. They put you out instead of pulling you in, which Jesus said, I would leave 99 to go after the one that's lost. That preacher deserves payment. But the preacher who cares the less should get nothing and should get less, because the Bible says that those who minister about holy things live of the things of the temple. That's what the Bible says. My friend, I'm one crying out in the wilderness. I bless you today for being here with me and being with me in this ministry tonight. Remember our subject tonight, that we're talking about preaching for payment. I wish I had more time to speak more of this gospel. But tonight, I thank you for listening tonight, preaching for payment. So then, yes, I should have in my heart the mission of Jesus Christ as a preacher. I should have in my heart the souls of men. Because if I'm not sowing seed of holiness, if I'm not serving God and preaching his gospel, if I'm not watering some seed, if I'm not tending to the sheep, if I'm not helping the blind, the poor, the withered, and preaching the gospel to those who are downtrodden, or lost, and confused, and scattered, if I'm not doing these things, then I cannot be called a man of God. Neither am I worthy of any payment from anybody. But there's some preachers who have stole the money from the preachers who deserve it. And God knows who you are. My friend, thank you for being here tonight. May the peace of God, the blessings of God be upon you. May God bless you tonight. And may God help you to be such a man of God that he's pleased with. For the Bible speaks unto the angels of the church. The Spirit of the Lord speaks clearly to us, the preachers, who should seek God, study to show ourselves approved unto God, rightly divide the word of truth, lead the people the way that they ought to go. Tell them the truth of God. Don't tell them the stuff that keep them here in the earth. Tell them about the things that are holy so that they can reach the holy of holies. Don't tell them of these things more than the things of God. Preach the gospel, which is that of Jesus Christ. Then can you reach the place that God wants you to reach? Thank you for being here. I'm Minister West and host of One Crying Out in the Wilderness Gospel News. Each Wednesday night, 6 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, I will be here preaching the word the Lord, sound doctrine. If you want the things that tickle the ear, I would suggest you turn off this ministry, because the only thing that will be preached from here is what I've been called to do, is preach sound doctrine. Thank you, my friend. God bless you. May heaven smile upon you, and may the peace of God be with you. In Jesus' name.
Thank you for joining One Crying Out in the Wilderness Gospel News Ministry. If you would like to donate to this ministry, you may do so by following the PayPal link described on this page. May the good Lord we serve bless you and keep you. Peace be unto you.